Hello everyone, I am Maheshwari Shahane. I am pursuing MSc Physics from Rashtra Sant Tukdoji Maharaj Nagpur University campus. Today I am going to discuss about the method of successive approximation using iteration method.
Hello everyone, I am Janvi Kaiskar. I am pursuing MSc Physics from Rashtra Sant Tukdoji Maharaj Nagpur University. I am going to discuss about successive approximation using iteration method.
I am going to discuss about successive approximation using iteration method.
Now let us talk about root finding method. There are two types of root finding methods. Number one, bracketing method, and number two, open methods. Bracketing methods determine successively smaller intervals or brackets that contains a root. Bracketing methods such as bisection method and false position method. Now let us talk about open method. Open methods differ from bracketing methods in that open methods require only a single starting values or two starting values that do not necessarily bracket a root. There are three types of open methods. Number one, iteration method. Number two, Newton-Raphson method. And number three, second method. Now, let us talk about open methods. In scientific and engineering studies, a frequently occurring problem is to root of equations of the form fx is equal to 0. We construct a formula xn plus 1 is equal to 5xn to predict the root intervally until x converges to a root. However, x may diverge.
Now let us talk about iteration method. Iteration method is known as one-point iteration or successive substitution or direct substitution method. The method is used for finding an approximate solution and equation. Fx is equal to 0. We rewrite the equation is the form of x is equal to 5x. Let x0 be an approximate value of the desired root section. Substituting it for x on the right side of the equation 2, we obtain the first approximation x1 is equal to 5x0. The successive approximations are then given by x2 is equal to 5x1, x3 is equal to 5x2, and xn is equal to 5xn minus 1.
A number of questions now arise. Does the sequence of approximation x0, x1, 2xn always converge to some number sections? It's negative. Number 2. If it does, will be a root of the equation x is equal to 5xn? Number 3. How should we choose phi in order that the sequence x0, x1, xn converge to the root?
Now let us talk about convergence criteria for iteration method. By the iteration method, we get a sequence of xn which converge to the root of the given equation. Lower the value of phi dash x, fewer the iterations are required to get the approximate solution.
The rate of convergence is more if the value of phi dash x is smaller.
Let's understand this iteration method by taking one example. Our question is, use the method of iteration to find a root of the equation cos x is equals to 3x minus 1. So, the given equation is cos x is equals to 3x minus 1. Shift this 3x minus 1 on the left side of the equal to sign. So, this becomes f of x is equals to cos x minus 3x plus 1 is equals to 0. Now, put x is equals to 0. So, f of x becomes f of 0 is equals to cos 0 minus 3 into 0 plus 1. So, f of 0 is equals to, as we know that cos 0 is 1 minus 3 into 0 will be 0 plus 1. So, we will get 2 and this is the positive value. Now, put x is equals to 1. So, f of x becomes f of 1 is equals to cos 1 minus 3 into 1 plus 1. If we calculate this value, we get f of 1 is equals to minus 1.460. This is the negative value. We get one positive value and one negative value, and hence its roots lies between 0 and 1. Now we have to convert our equation in the form of x. So our equation is cos x is equals to 3x minus 1, and so shift this 1 on the left side of the equal to sign. So it is minus 1, now it will be plus 1, and equation becomes cos x plus 1 is equals to 3x. And now shift this 3. Initially it is in multiplication. If we shift this about the equal to sign, so it will be in the divide. So our equation is x is equals to cos x plus 1 divided by 3. So as I had told earlier, iteration method is applied when phi dash of x is less than 1. Then the series will be convergent. So first of all, let's calculate phi dash of x and check whether it is convergent or not. Now our equation is phi x is equals to cos x plus 1 divided by 3. We denote this equation by phi x. Now calculate phi dash of x. Let's do differentiation and it is denoted by phi dash. Now we know that differentiation of cos x is minus sin x and differentiation of 1 is 0. So phi dash of x is equals to minus sin x divided by 3. Now let's check it's convergent or not. As we have calculated f of 0 and f of 1, our root is lies between 0 and 1. So first of all, I take mod of phi dash of x. So mod of phi dash of x is equals to mod of minus sine of x divided by c. So it becomes mod of phi dash of x is equals to sine x upon 3. So if we put any value in the mod, then it will be positive. That's why it will be positive sine x upon 3. So if we put phi dash of 0 is equals to, so we put sine of 0 divided by 3, and we know that sine 0 is 0 divided by 3, so it will be 0, which is less than 1. So now let's check for f dash of 1. So sine of 1 is divided by 3. So sine 1 is equals to, if we calculate sine 1, we will get 0.01745 and divided by 3, so it will become 0.005817, which value is less than 1. Hence our series is convergent, because our phi dash of x is we check the value of phi dash of x and which is less than 1. Hence our series is convergent. Now let's calculate the approximations. Our f of 0 is 0. So for the first approximation, we take, let's say x1, we take x is equals to 0. So phi of x of 0 is equals to cos 0 plus 1 divided by 3. As we know that cos 0 is 1 plus 1 divided by 3. So it will be 2 by 3. And we calculate this, we will get 0.667 approximately. Now we have to take what value we get for the x1. We have to use it for the x2. So x2 is equals to phi of x 0.667. So it will be cos of 0.667 plus 1 divided by 3. Now cos of 0.667 will be 0.7856 plus 1 divided by 3. So it becomes 0.5953. Now calculate x3. So we will use x2 for the calculation of the x3. It means we put x is equals to 0.5953. So phi of x of 0.5953 is equals to cos of 0.5953 plus 1 5953 plus 1 divided by 3. So we will get cos of 0.5953 is 0.827980 plus 1 divided by 3, and our final value will be 0.6093. Let's calculate in the similar way for the x4. So phi of x 0.6093 will be cos of 0.6093 plus 1 divided by 3. We will get 0.820048 plus 1 divided by 3, and our final value of x4 will be 0.6071. So now you can see our value is going to similar up to 2 decimal places, and so our approximation root is 0.6071. For the solving of iteration method, we have keep in mind that we have to put values like 0, 1 to check that base value, our first value for f of 0 and f of 1, that should be 1 positive and 1 negative. In the next step, to calculate phi dash of x, we have to make our equation in the form of x, and this equation we represented by phi x, and now differentiate the equation to obtain the phi dash of x. Now check if this value is convergent or not. How will you check this value? If the value of phi dash of x is less than 1, then it will be convergent. Now further, we will calculate the approximate value. So now we will check the application of the iteration method. The fixed point iteration method in the numerical analysis is used to find an approximate solution to the algebraic transcendental's equation. A major advantage of iteration method is that round off errors are not given a chance to accumulate, as they are in the Gaussian elimination and the Gauss-Jordan method because each iteration essentially creates a new approximation to the solution. So in this video, we have seen that what is the difference between bracketing method and open method for locating the roots, and then we will see the introduction of the iteration method, convergence criteria for the iteration method, geometrical significance, and one example that how to calculate the iteration method, and then we have see the example. That's all we have to say about it. Thank you.